Hi, welcome to Video Game Animation Study. We're continuing a mini-series looking at the five fundamentals of video game animation as proposed by Jonathan Cooper in his book Game Anim, Video Game Animation Explained. Previously, we've looked at the fundamental of feel, arguably the most important of the five, as how a character feels to play will determine your enjoyment and immersiveness of the game. And we looked at fluidity last time, where we covered the transition animations between character actions and how this helps or hinders the feel of a character. This time we're looking at the fundamental of readability. This episode is sponsored by Squarespace, the place to build your online presence. So what is readability? This is how your character will look or read from all angles, or what angle will be best to animate your character from. Readability is similar to and derivative of the classic staging animation principle, which is how your action is composed on screen, although because game animators have no control over how an animation will be seen by the audience, they have to be much more thorough in the animation process. A game animator, particularly one for a third-person action game, will have to construct and critique their character's animation from all angles, in the same way a sculptor works, as Jonathan suggests. Something that will ensure your animation looks good from all angles will be to avoid creating actions and motion that flow through one particular axis. For instance, if you were to view a stabbing motion from the front or behind of your character, you wouldn't have any clarity on this movement, but you would from the side or above. Something like an arc or a swipe would read quite well, as this motion would naturally flow through a number of axes. So viewing this action from a number of different angles will reveal an interesting pose, and more importantly, communicate to the player just exactly what's going on. Action in third person will likely be textured in this way to keep each motion looking interesting and appealing. You may notice that as well as moving the character forward, other body parts will have twists and shifts across other axes too. Arms, legs, torso, and head movement should not be contained to one particular axis, and instead be moving through all three. This will ensure the movement will look appealing from any angle. Something else that will aid the appeal and readability of a move will be the silhouette of a character. This is how the outline of a character looks, and some of the best character designs you'll be able to recognize in a matter of seconds. Whether that's a big head with spikes, or a short, stocky cap-wearing guy, or a stealthy mercenary. Quick game, pause the screen now and guess how many silhouettes you can recognize and put your answers in the comments below. A game animator should get involved early on with guiding the look of a character to enable better construction, which makes the job of creating appealing animation easier. As with any character concept, you'll want to avoid stiff, shapeless, and uninteresting designs, and anything which might make posing the character difficult, like big plates of armor over joints and such. For instance, Samus's illustrative design for the Super Nintendo doesn't appear to lend itself well to exaggerated flexibility, though this isn't the version that's being animated, as this is switched for the pixel art within the game itself. However, once we reach Metroid Other M, those big bulky shoulder pads have been reworked for animation purposes, allowing much more dexterity in-game. During character creation and animation, it greatly helps a player understand movement when the animator considers the center of gravity of a character. This refers both to the character model in-game, such as where the center of character is in relation to the game world, where they'll pivot and everything, but it also refers to the animation itself. A player may notice when an animation looks wrong in a game, but not necessarily know why, such as the foot sliding issue I've talked about in Mega Man X7. But when you carefully consider just how a character moves in relation to their center of gravity, you'll notice improvements, both in creating a readable pose and the motion of the character. Knowing where the weight will be as your character moves, such as where the body and feet will be when leaning forward, will help you understand how to pose them, and in turn help the player understand the move easily. Another thing which might help your design process is deciding how realistic or stylistic your aesthetics will be. Let's look at Mario and Arthur and how they attack. At the most extreme pose of these actions, how do the characters look from the angle you'll likely view them from the most? And how do they look from the side? And then the front? How do they look from far away? An important thing to remember, Jonathan says, are the three C's. Camera, character, and control. Control will feed back into feel, how a character feels when playing. Character relates to a few things, including just how exactly your character moves in accordance to their personality, such as Batman moving in a foreboding, stern way, and Spider-Man moving in a laid-back, juvenile way. And camera is something that will affect how readable your character's actions are. Game Maker's Toolkit has a fantastic video covering this topic, and it feeds into this fundamental really well, so I thoroughly suggest checking that video out, as it will greatly help you understand this fundamental more. In essence, the camera can affect how clearly your actions are read, depending how close or far it is. Sometimes the camera is close, sometimes it's far, sometimes it auto-follows, and sometimes you have control, and sometimes it's fixed. Sometimes it'll be all of these in turn. You might want to push more exaggerated animation for characters that are constantly far away from the camera, and hold more reserved, nuanced animation for those close cameras. Then you've got first person, which is a whole other thing that we'll get into another time. How loose or tight a camera feels can affect your involvement with the character too, meaning the difference between feeling involved and feeling like an observer. And this can be tweaked depending on what you need, such as when cameras zoom in slightly for when you take on a more aggressive or defensive approach. That all said, it also entirely depends on what your game is. If your game is mostly being seen from the side, then focus on polishing animations that read well when seen from the side. If your running animation is mostly going to be seen from the rear, then prioritize how that animation looks when seen from behind. If your camera is mostly far away, then push for more exaggerated poses so they can be seen easier. If you've got a fighting game, push for interesting poses that are mostly seen from the side. Now obviously, a lot of this information has been geared towards 3D character models in third-person games, but this will apply to games that are 2D and hand-drawn as well. For instance, if you're drawing a fighting game, you're much more likely to draw a character from a three-quarter angle than exactly side-on, as you'll see more information about your character and be able to create interesting and readable poses from there, switching to side-on for a more dynamic pose. Maybe your character's body is facing towards the screen or even behind them, with their head leading the direction. In fact, you could probably point to any 2D game in the past 30 years and your character will almost always be seen from a three-quarter angle, particularly in idle poses, with perhaps the odd exception. An interesting little thing to think about there. So, this is what readability is. Considering how your action looks from all angles, taking into account your camera and your character. Thanks again to Jonathan Cooper. And thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. I've had a chance at making my own Squarespace website now, though it needs tweaking so it's unshareable just yet, but it's really easy to use and has loads of things to make your site look and feel unique. You've got stuff that links to your social media, PayPal, Trolley, a whole host of stuff. So use my link in the description to start a free trial to check Squarespace out for yourself, and when you're ready to launch, use my coupon code for 10% off your first purchase for a website or domain. And thanks to my patrons for also funding this episode. Random shout out to DB Root. A cosmic coincidence, there's a Root who sponsors me. It's not planned, honest.